up, guys? It's Kid Lips.
And it's your boy Groovies. Welcome to downtown Los Angeles. Thanks for joining us today.
We also have cool sunglasses on.
We got our cool shades.
Because we're going to talk about computer stuff. And when you're going to talk about cool stuff like computers, you got to look cool.
Nerd out. Total nerd out. Right now. Right now.
Or that.
Today, we're going to talk about a completely free version of probably the most important design tool for your computer, Adobe Illustrator, Adobe Photoshop.
Adobe Illustrator and Photoshop are free?
Ethan, what do you use Photoshop for?
Yo! So there's two major programs that I use from Adobe Creative Suite, Photoshop and Illustrator. Photoshop is great for editing photos, right? You can take a photo, you can manipulate it, you can edit it as you need, you can change coloring, you can freak it. You do all sorts of different things with a photo and then make that ready for your production. Illustrator is more oriented around graphic, right? It's oriented around things like text or a logo or a pattern, something that's been drawn that's not a photograph, and then it can be turned into a vector, it can be created as a vector. And that means you can scale it up and down, it's not gonna lose quality. You can get it ready for production. You can do print separations. If you're doing screen printing, you can have multiple colors separated on different layers. It's a super powerful tool for general graphics. So, good to know the differences and where they have strengths and weaknesses. Today we're gonna talk about some alternatives that are also available if you're not trying to spend all that money on that Adobe suite to get something equally sweet.
If you are balling on a budget, Adobe can be a little bit expensive. And if you don't wanna pay 30 bucks a month, you have other options.
Groovies, give us the goods.
There's free versions of Adobe Photoshop and Adobe Illustrator. They're not made by Adobe, but they are really, really well supported versions that have really nice communities built around them. If you're looking to replace or get into Photoshop, you should definitely check out Gimp. We'll throw the logo up there. We'll give you a link to the website. You can download it there for free. Everything that you can do in Photoshop, you can do in GIMP. And the replacement tool for Adobe Illustrator is Inkscape. We'll give you the logo. We'll give you a link to the website. Go download it, check it out. Again, totally free. It's a vector-based tool. So you can plot the points, you can plot the lines, you can trace raster images and turn them into vector art. Knowing Inkscape and GIMP and working in those two tool sets, sky's the limit. You can do just about anything when it comes to graphic design.
I feel like Groovies was talking for a while. I wanted to mix it up. Sorry. I got impatient.
That's okay.
Cool.
It's going to be weird to cut into this from a production standpoint now.
Welcome to the rest of your life. Anyway, thank you. Thank you, Groovies. Thank you, Downtown.
Yeah, we're going to be making these videos once a week, brand hack videos, just building, growing your brand, growing yourself as a brand. Hit the subscribe button.
Hit the subscribe button. Subscribe the button.
One video. Oh, no biggie.
No smally. Just right.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Peace be with you.
Later.
Is this your Porsche?
Could be.
Could be.
I'll take it.
I'll take it. Blanca.
That's not Blanca, but should be.
She's white.
What?
You trading your group? Trade her up like that? No questions asked.
Yesterday I was talking to Elvis Ellis, this artist, about painting Blanca.
Oh, really?
Might do it.
Like permanent oil paint or like a semi-permanent?
Not permanent. Okay. Like paint the thing.
Wow.
Could be dope.
What, like a mural type situation?
Like flat or like Jackson Pollock.
Pollock it?
They were like, yo, you'll be peacocking in that thing. I'm like, yeah, that's true. I don't know if I'm trying to be that much of a peacock, but it would be dope.